Prosumerism, user innovation, and customization. The profound awareness of one's own needs and the tendency to privilege the symbolic meaning of goods as an expression of one's own identity have increasingly encouraged consumers of the knowledge society to manipulate the outputs of enterprises, both on the semantic level, through the attribution of meaning, and on the one related to tangible characteristics and components, giving life to the idea of prosumerism. Some subjects, that for their particular and innovative skills take the name of lead user, have come to develop into solutions that meet their needs and, in some industrial sectors, are even the architects of most new products and services. The innovations created by users, defined user-driven innovation, or simply user innovation, include changes made directly to the goods produced by a company, proposals for changes in design and our own property submitted to an organization, and products created in a complete and personal way. Seizing this trend, some companies, Nike and Levi's among the first, decided to involve customers in their creative activities on their own initiative, allowing them to customize standard articles through a platform on the company website. This first step taken by organizations toward the possibility of voluntarily involving consumers in production cycles is described as mass customization and consists of the attempt to combine mass production with customization, maintaining cost efficiency and developing greater flexibility and ability to meet the specific needs of individuals. One aspect of the customization activity performed by customers that is particularly significant and apparently paradoxical is its free nature, considerable as an emblem of the main motivation that pushes consumers to do their job, that is the satisfaction obtainable through the subsequent consumption of the personalized product and often also through the creative action itself. Over time, the collaboration of companies with users has intensified, in particular addressing the co-creation of new offers together with the lead users, which are in fact recognized of the features that can be advantageously exploited in the problem-solving processes of the organizations and above all in innovation projects. Specifically, von Hippel identified two distinctive elements of these consumers: the ability to predict market trends, experiencing first of the needs that will emerge in the future in the entire population of which they are part, and the great motivation to identify a solution that satisfies them, determined by the high benefit they can derive from it. These two aspects are strongly correlated with the likelihood that lead users to engage in the development of new products or in the modification of existing ones, further increased by their significant degree of expertise. As a result, as it has been demonstrated by several studies, most of the user innovations are carried out by subjects belonging to the category of lead users, and even the attractiveness they exert toward the companies and the intention of the latter to translate them into commercial products increase proportionally compared to the extent to which the designers have this connotation. These dynamics are the prelude to open innovation, of which crowdsourcing is sometimes defined as one of the key techniques, and which in any case provides many collaborative ideas and development elements to this model of joint problem solving. In close connection with the ambition of consumers to become producers, the phenomenon of amateurs has arisen, who realize by passion and without receiving a form of income the same task that other specialized subjects perform by profession. The amateur rebirth, which stimulates, among other things, the collaboration between people with professional backgrounds and very different skills, is defined by Howe as the fuel for the crowdsourcing engine. One factor that has greatly influenced the rise of amateur activities, and consequently also the development of crowdsourcing, is the search for rewarding experiences outside the work environment, prompted in turn by the high rate of job dissatisfaction, caused by demand from the world of work of ever greater levels of specialization and the resulting impossibility of many individuals to feel fulfilled, despite the quality of their training and the variety of interests and knowledge. Thanks to the increasing degree of education of the company, to the ease of access to information, favored by the dissemination of news and knowledge through the web, and to a sort of democratization of the production instruments, extremely cheaper and easier to use, the heritage of knowledge and skills, that both consumers and amateurs are in possession of, is increasingly richer and allows them to compete with professionals substantially in all fields of knowledge, information technology, journalism, science, etc. This leads to the emergence of the figure of the prosumer and that of the pro-am, identified by Charles Ledbetter and Paul Miller and resumed by Howe, which shares the quantity and quality of the commitment lavished by the amateur, such as to compare it to professional work. The appearance and the emergence of these subjects have certainly played an important role in the development of crowdsourcing, but the people that make up the crowd, and to which the organizations can therefore turn for a collaborative problem-solving action, not necessarily can be qualified as prosumers and proem according to their precise definition. In fact, crowdsourcing can involve individuals potentially endowed with any degree of specialization and professionalism, experts in the field, scientists of the discipline, fans of the subject, consumers of the product, etc., but generally united by the desire to participate and lend their own work in a specific project mainly not for an economic return but for reasons related to pleasure, interest, leisure, and personal satisfaction. Crowdsourcing can provide for forms of material compensation, i.e., prizes and rewards of various entities, which can encourage participation, but these do not prevail over amateur reasons.